Hey everybody, it is Dave, back today to talk about a brand new projector we have in front of us. This is the NEC NP605UL. So this is a 6,000 lumen laser 3 LCD unit. So let me just stop there for a second and explain that. The 6,000 lumens, really bright, no matter what you have, lamp, laser. That's going to be useful in a university type lecture hall, school setting, auditorium, anywhere where you're going to have a substantial amount of people sitting around and you need some bright images for them to read and view. It's going to work great in that. The laser part of that just ensures that the life of that light source is going to last for a very long time, and it's going to maintain a very consistent brightness almost at 6,000 lumens, probably for the lifetime of the projector, whereas a lamp would start to die off after a few months, starts to get dimmer and dimmer over time. So that's a big advantage right there. The other advantage is that this is an LCD unit, a 3 LCD. So with that comes the kind of a better picture quality. A lot of people think it's better picture quality. I'm one of those people. You have the same white brightness as you do the same color brightness with a 3 LCD. So you get a beautifully bright image that's not too bright in some colors and less bright in others. It's consistent all the way across. And that is a big selling feature for this unit. The other cool thing about this unit regarding the color quality and the image clarity is their incorporation of their AccuBlend technology. So what that means is NEC has some internal software that works. It's kind of like a scaler, I guess, that takes whatever source you're feeding into this, and whenever that outputs it, it makes it look beautiful and crisp and like it was its native aspect ratio. So this is a 1920 by 1200 WUXGA projector, but it is capable of accepting 4K inputs and 1280 by 800 inputs and all of those, and you'll get a consistent image no matter what you use. So that's the core thing I want to talk about there. The other thing I want to talk about is placement flexibility of this. The throw ratio on this projector is really good. We're talking around 1.2 to 2.1. So for an example, let's say you have a 20-foot diagonal screen. You'd want to put this between 20 and 30 feet back. So there's a nice range of motion there. Obviously, if you're going to have a smaller screen, then it's going to be closer. But you do need to check and see how big an image you want to place before you purchase this and make sure it fits in your room, your setup. It's also got a nice 1.6 optical zoom in the front. So even if you have it set up somewhere towards the front or towards the back and you need a bigger image, you can use that zoom to make sure you get that set up. If your placement is off just a little bit in the mounting, no worries. It's got very capable lens shift in here. We're talking around 40% horizontal and I think around 60% vertical. So does not have to be picture perfect when you install it, just pretty close, and you can use the dials to just move that picture exactly where it needs to be, and then you're off to the races. Let's talk a little bit about the inputs, and then we'll take a look at this thing in action. Great, so now we are looking at the back of the 605UL. These are all the inputs that NEC has plugged in here for us. Starting left to right, we have a powered USB. We have your VGA computer in. You have dual HDMIs. Again, these do accept 4K signals, but they output in WUXGA, just so you know. We have your Ethernet and HDB. This has got a built-in HD base T receiver. So if you have long cable runs set up and you don't want to run a bunch of HDMI or VGA cables all the way, this is fantastic. It's a lifesaver. You can run it all through Cat 6. However, you will need a HD base C, HD base T transmitter on the other side. So if you need that, call us, we can help you out. You also have your LAN ports here, which is great for your control if you have this plugged into your network. And you have your audio in, you have a variable audio out, so you can use the remote for that. And you have your PC right there, so you can control it. There's your IR, and you should have one on the front so that you can use your remote to connect this thing from anywhere. I do want to kind of take a look at the sides of this unit while we've got this thing right here. Just tell me if that's about right. Okay, so we have the menu options. This is a really handy feature. It's not required by any means, but it does come in nice in case you ever lose a remote to have the menu items right on the side of the projector. So they're all very handy, not too much to worry about. You have your source inputs, your power. One thing is that when you plug this in, it's basically powered on. It's ready to go. So the startup is super quick. There's a standby mode, which is basically power off, but it's always powered. So it's very fast on and off. And then you obviously have Keystone settings. Because it's a laser unit, it's a sealed casing. There's no real need for maintenance or filtering on this. It has a really long life warranty. It has a 20 watt speaker, which is great for like small auditoriums or lecture halls. Probably plenty loud enough for a speaker to talk through that and be heard by the audience. And then on the front, right here, is that about right? Okay. You have your lens, and then nice, beautiful, smooth. That's your zoom, and then your fine focus right there. A little bit tougher, but not, I mean, you don't want that to be really loose because you want to keep your focus where it's at. So that works good. And then up top, this is really about the only thing that I could say isn't a super durable feeling piece of this unit. And that's really a minor gripe because you're only going to use this probably once or twice once it's installed. This is your lens shift options. So the dials themselves feel fine. Pretty smooth, a little loose maybe, but the actual casing and the cover, just could feel a little bit more durable, but once it's plugged in, it's all good to go. And then underneath, we have our feet, which are nice, fine and functional if you don't need to install it onto the wall, onto a mount, and you want to use that in the classroom. But these feet are plastic, just keep that in mind. And you have your power and indicator lights. So that is the P605UL. We found a different video here. This is one of New York. This is 4K. So this is what we did was we put it into graphic mode here. It seemed like it had the best, kind of most even color settings. We're going to leave it there. And we'll just talk a little bit about some of these other features. So I did mention the 20 watt speaker setup that we have inside of here, which I can turn up and down from the remote. So sorry about that. It sounds like we're outside. That's just New York for you. And it also has a digital zoom. So if you're in a classroom setting and you need to show certain parts of an image or a video, you can do that. You have the option to freeze an image and then zoom into that image. Well, let's try that. So you have the option to freeze, you have the option to zoom in digitally, but you cannot freeze and then zoom in. So the last couple of things that I forgot to mention when I was talking directly to the camera are the contrast ratio on this projector. So this is a 600,000:1 contrast ratio, which is really, really good. That's, you know, home theater level contrast, and you can tell here in the dark areas versus the white areas, just how stark that difference is. But it doesn't sacrifice the color and the rest of the image, so it's really, really nice. And then you also have the ability to dial that in through the actual menu.